Rosen, Timbo! Hej! Yeah! Hope y'all ready to boogie, cause we are. Enjoy some good rock and roll, some good blues, man. Guarantee you. Dennis McNamara from LIRFM. Tonight we're coming to you from my father's place. The latest album is on Blue Sky Records, White, Hot, and Blue. It's with great pride we present the WLIRFM, Johnny Winter. Thank you.
way down low. Nobody done this in a long time, so better keep this mic down pretty low here to play a little harder. Not that low. Higher than that, a lot higher than John Pierce on bass. Good for that. Yeah, check this out. Good stuff. Yeah.
Thank you.
did those two instrumentals because I wanted to get warmed up because they were two songs by one of my favorite guitar players, Freddie King. And it makes all of us feel real good to play those songs, you know, makes us feel real good to play those tunes. No, we're sleeping now. Yeah. Okay, let's see now. Oh yeah, oh yeah, I was gonna do one of those songs. Where was who's that had that record. I'm gonna tell you this, we're gonna do the song off. This is the a new record, White, Hot, and Blue. And so I'm gonna do one of the songs off of it that Little Walter did first called Last Night. I'm gonna do it for you right now. Don't worry, man. We got about 3 hours. I'm gonna blow you away. Totally blow you away. Don't worry about that. Rip it out.
Tom Pierce on harp. They tell me every day things better change. They tell me way from tomorrow. Better give us some appreciation, cause we're gonna get it sooner or later. Tell me every day things better change. You know I love you, baby. You know I stay crying, sing. Yeah, I'm making myself up. Watch out now. Yeah. Cougar.
Thank you. All right, thank you. So let me tell you what we're trying to do, see. What we're trying to do is the first band that I've had that, to where the whole band doesn't just get paid for what they're supposed to do. This band really enjoys and does a good job of playing blues and rock and roll. We like both blues and rock and roll. My personal preference happens to be that I like the blues better than about anything else, but, you know. But I still dig doing rock and roll. And a show like this where we've got several hours. See, that's what we can do, man. We can make everybody happy. We can play all the blues and all the rock and roll and everything that y'all want to hear. Yeah, that's the main thing that we're trying to do, is to show you people that there aren't these fucking ridiculous barriers within music. Like, I'm a blues person, I'm a rock and roll person, I'm a hillbilly person, I'm a jazz. It's just music, it's good music. And there's one guy right there just blowing it. Right, oh, you know, of rock and roll is great. Yeah, blues is great. But all music is great, and if you can just learn to understand it and listen to it, you might find things that you don't like, but you can still appreciate. And it's really really closed-minded to just decide, I only want to hear blues, I only want to hear rock and roll, I only want to go to a concert if I'm rolling on a playlist, or if I'm, fucked up on whatever, you know, but it's really important to us. The music means a whole lot to us, and so does the way that we're trying to present the music that we're playing, because it means a lot to all of us, and we hope it means a lot to you all, too. And just, you know, I mean, we're really getting off on playing for you people. Let me just say that right now. We're really enjoying playing for you all. Jiving a bit. Okay, we'll give you some blues. I think it's about time for some rock and roll. Yeah, you know. Why not, you know? I like doing that too. A lot of people that believe that I'm supposed to be only a blues person feel like I'm committing a sacrilege when I play a rock and roll song, but, you know, all I can say is, fuck you, because I like rock and roll, too. You know, I like doing both things, and here we go. Check this out. Thank you. I'm going to introduce them later, but just because they're such cool people, such great musicians, and such good friends of mine, I just want to tell you right now that we got on bass John Turris. Who also writes a lot of the songs, sings, plays harmonica, plays guitar. And on drums, on drums, Bobby T, Bobby Tirolo. And you haven't seen the Bobby do his number yet, so right now I'm just gonna do a little bit of slide stuff, so y'all just keep it down.
Thank you.
and doing a little bit more rock and roll here. See, the only kind of rock and roll that I do is like 50s and 60s rock and roll, because I quit listening to the radio about 10 years ago. And I haven't found any reason to start listening again. You know, only when I have a record that is getting played. But usually, you know, radio in New York, and New York City is pretty crappy. And Long Island is pretty nice, really. In fact, when I'm staying out here, I really like the hell out of Long Island radio, but somehow it's kind of different in New York. So what I'm really trying to do is have a good time for me, for my band, and make sure that you people have a good time too, you know? And to do that, it used to be a lot harder than it is now, because people used to think of me as like, he's either a blues singer or a rock and roll singer, but now I've got enough time to sing both kinds of music. Unless you people get frustrated, unless somebody wants to hear, you know, 4 hours of rock and roll or 4 hours of blues, then you're gonna get upset. But I'm gonna try to do everything for you. Everything, because I like singing and playing and everything, and so is my group. So I hope that means something to you, and definitely I will do Johnny Be Good later, but not right now. I'm gonna do an older rock and roll song that this is before Johnny Be Good even. But some of y'all might have heard it from your fathers, mothers, big brothers, big sisters. Check it out and see if you have. You might like it. Try it. Try it. You like it. I told you so. Wasn't so bad. My Suzy Q. Thank you. I like the way you walk. I like the way you talk. I like the way you walk. I like the way you talk. My music cue. Yeah. I say that you'll be true. I say that you'll be true. I say that you'll be true. And never be blue. Yeah, just get way on down now. Yeah. How many of you people are really old enough to remember when Dale Hawkins did this song? Did any of y'all remember that song? Does anybody truthfully remember Dale Hawkins doing Susie Q? Yeah, that's what I, yeah, no. Okay, let's see. Let me see, who after that? Does anybody remember Creedence Clearwater doing something? I guarantee you, the best version was the Dale Hawkins version, man. That's just what I was gonna say. I hope that 20 years from now, when somebody asks you which version you like best, that you like mine best, because I'm gonna get this, you know. Because I like the song, it's just been done so many times, but man, Dale Hawkins' version was a real killer. Okay. Well, before I get into my really old-fashioned 1957 killer, I'm just gonna kinda play around with it a little bit. We're gonna do it kinda soft and pretty for just a little while. Tease you a little bit. Thank you. lot of fun to me. Singing on this, and I just want to tell you one thing that you people that weren't around when Happy Days and all that stuff was coming out. The 1950s were not like none of that shit. I guarantee you that. Yeah, there were a lot of professional virgins, but still there were a lot of them. A lot of real nice chicks that I had a real good time with in the back of, whatever. I mean, it's just more secretive like in the 50s, you know. Now you can talk about it. In the 50s, you just couldn't do it. Nobody could do it, but everybody did it. I mean, no matter whether you could do it or not, everybody did it. I mean, who's gonna stop doing it because somebody says you can't do it? Well, fuck you, we're gonna do it anyhow, you know, so, you know. I've had so many different names that you wouldn't even... I think it's about time to really get in some really... Okay, this is kind of a 1978 version, but still, even though it's a 1978 version, it's pretty damn close to what somebody would have about 57. 1, 2, 3, 4... Thank you. could break my E string. I like the way you walk. I like the way you talk. I like the way you walk. I like the way you talk. My Susie Q. Susie Q. I'm not sure speak enough to want to hear some slag guitar. Well, you're gonna get it, Ben. Yeah, I'm a slide move, man. You slide right up everybody's ass. Well, Watch out now. Be careful for me. This ain't what you really call, I guess, rock and roll. I guess you'd call it. Well, you can call it whatever you want to call it. It's just, no, it's not always rock and roll. See, that's what the weird thing about me is that I really love blues and rock and roll. And I do a combination of both of them and try to make both of you. Takes the people happy, the people that like me here and like to hear me play rock and roll, people like to hear me play blues. I love both kinds, and I like to play both sorts of music. If you people will stay here long enough, I'll damn sure play enough of both kinds for you to drive you nuts and be ready to go home. So you don't have to worry about, you know, screaming for songs or nothing, because you're going to get your songs. Okay, all you gotta wait is for me to get tuned up here. And one other thing, don't let, I mean, really, it's not fair, like, you know, like, don't let, you know, don't, the rock and roll freaks don't get mad at the blues freaks, the blues freaks don't get mad at the rock and roll freaks. I'm gonna do everything, I'm gonna do all of it for you. So just give, you know, if you just like rock and roll and hate blues, you know, just go take a piss or something, you know. Because I'm going to do the whole thing for you. I'm going to do all of it for you. So just check it out, you know. Have a good time listening, because we're having a good time playing, okay? Well, you know what I do? Let me try to explain this too. One thing that I've always done, instead of explaining things, I've always just screamed real loud, which has been real nice. It's released my tensions, and I guarantee it'll work. But see, now I'm really trying to explain to you people, because I mean, you people have obviously wanted to hear what I'm doing, or you wouldn't be here. So I really, really respect and love you people for wanting to be here. So I want to play the music that makes you all happy and makes you feel good. No, I really mean that. And plus, I want to find out what does make you happy and what makes you unhappy. You know, all the different things that are going on. But I'm sitting here. I'm not drinking water, so I'm not. I'm not stone sober either. But I just want to, you know. I'd like all of you all to be, aware that there's people that like different kinds of music than. Okay, but right now, okay, we've done a lot of rock and roll. Right now, I'm going to do a Stone Blues. I'm going to Stone Blues sing for you. Called Come On In My Kitchen by Robert Johnson. And the hardcore rockers, just try to remember that if it wasn't for blues, there wouldn't be no rock and roll. So, it's a nice line, but it's true. It's really true. Yeah, I can't claim to have invented this stuff, but I can claim that I'm going to play it real good for you. real good for you, so y'all check it out. Yeah, you blues people are gonna like this. Again, did I come out in my kitchen? God is going to be raining out there. gonna get some trouble. Everybody throws it down. She looked for our good friends. You know they can't be found. Watch out for yourself. Better come on in my kitchen. It's going to be raining outdoors. Yes, well, he's just like, yeah. Yes, my good friend, that. Everybody has troubles. It's a lot easier to think they have somebody else. The blues people used to think you gotta be a black to have the blues, you gotta be poor to have the blues, you gotta be all sorts of different things to have the blues. If there ain't nobody out there, what the blues is being unhappy, man. Unhappy when you don't know why in the world you're unhappy. It ain't nothing right. Maybe you might have enough money to do anything you want, you man. You might have enough. You might have enough girlfriends or boyfriends to where you don't even need them. You might have enough clothes. And I guarantee you, I'm talking about what I know about. That don't make no difference at all. You can have all this stuff. Still have the blues, man. And you might be too high class and sophisticated to say I got the blues. You know, I got the blues, man. But that's a but it might be a higher class name, you know. You might go to a doctor and get some Reds, you know, get some Seconal, some Valiums, and that'll fix you up for a while. But and you know, and all your friends tell you, well, you just depressed? What's wrong with you? You just depressed, baby. Everything's gonna be okay. I'll just take 40 milligrams of Valium or shoot little tongues, you know, snort a lot of cocaine, everything will be okay. But let me tell you the truth about the whole thing is. You white people out there, but they read too many album covers. They read too many album covers that say that they only black people have blues, man. But everybody has a blues, man. And everybody has a blues. Black people have the blues. White people have the blues. But yeah, you damn right fucked up people got the blues. Yeah, you got that right, man. You got that right. But you might spend $75 a bit to your psychiatrist, and you might spend $300 worth a day on dope or on cocaine, but you still got the blues. You know, it makes you feel a little bit better. That makes you feel a hell of a lot better for a while. But you still got the blues, man. It don't make no difference. For a long time, it was just like, well, I gotta be poor. I gotta be... And I hope nobody that's black here takes this wrong, but you know, for a long time, it was figured you gotta be a poor black nigger to have the blues. And I don't mean nigger in the wrong way at all, because all my good friends were niggers. They didn't know what black people meant, you know? It's still the truth. Yeah, and the best thing you can do about doing the blues is you share it with other people, because there ain't nothing that's just gonna get rid of it. And the psychiatrists and all the pills and all the dope in the world ain't gonna help you get rid of it. You just gotta kinda deal with it. And realize that other people have the blues too, and it's still the same thing, whether you wanna call it depression, whatever you wanna call it, everybody's got it. Thank you. looking for good friends. No, they can't be found. Better come on in my kitchen. It's gonna be lucky and stole her back again. Better come on in my kitchen. You better come on in, baby. I sure hope I put that across in the right way, because it's something that really meant a whole lot to me, because I had to go through a lot of stuff that I didn't particularly want to go through. And I hope it came through. Okay, I hope it came across, you know. So, anyway, we got to do some more music for you right now. In fact, what we're gonna do right now is one that Jimmy Rogers did called "Walk Over Myself." It's also on the new record. Okay, I got an E string. I got a spritz. Yeah, boy, I like to stretch somebody's E string. That ain't gonna help much, John, because I gotta stretch this motherfucker out until I'm gonna do it from rear. Now wait just a minute, all it's in the wind. What's wrong with you people? How come y'all so cool, man? I mean, you know, Y'all are really cool people, man. We have a real good time playing for y'all. And, sometimes it's hard for us to tell exactly whether you're having a good time listening or not. We're still going to do our gig, you know, it's our job, you know, we get up here and try to play the best we can for you, and hope you like it, and if you hate it, then ain't nothing we can do about it, because as long as we play the best we can, that's the best we can do. This is what we're doing right now. I dig it, you know, I dig playing too. I dig it, but I've been through the whole trip, man. It's weird to see people all nodded out, you know, because I used to do the whole thing, you know. That's cool, you know. Well, it's not really cool. It's not really cool at all. It's not really cool at all, because you come home, you think, hey, what's the show? Well, I don't know, man. Yeah, I missed. Like, how about the first 15 minutes? And, okay, no, man, you know, the rest of it. You know, I've done that for years. It's a lot more fun once you spend your money to just at least look at what you, at least if you look at it and don't like it, you can walk out. When you're nodding out, you don't even know what the fuck you're doing. You know what you're doing. You just have to sit there. You know what I mean? No. Does anybody know what I'm saying here? What? Is that... Okay, this is Walking By Myself. John Paris gonna put it in the heart. Here we go. I'd a lot rather talk than, sing than preach. A lot rather. You got your heart, John? There, run them on over there. No, see, not now we're 61. See what we're trying to do? No. But that's a nice song. That's a nice song, too. But what we're trying to do, Gary, go ahead and hold up that album. See, this song comes off this album here, you know, this album right here that we just put out. And I'm real happy with this album, White, Hot, and Blue. And this is one that we got of this one. It's not just to sell records, man. It's not just to, make bread or nothing, because, we're just trying to do things that make us happy and make you all happy, too. Right now we're going to do... I already told you, if you was listening, I already told you, so here you go. Check it out. Yeah.
Thank you.
myself, I hope you understand. I just want to be your dollar man. this is gonna be kind of interesting to you people that grew up when I did. And I'm not really gonna tell you when I grew up, but it's probably earlier than you people did. And every band in the world did a drum solo, and every band in the world had a rotten, shitty fucking drummer. And we got a great drummer, so we're gonna do the same old shitty song that all of them did, except ours is gonna do a lot of different stuff. So check this out, Ben. Look out for it.
About the Buddy Holly story.
Remember Buddy Holly? Me and y'all about two or three years old, you know. Well, he was around there, you know, like 58, 59, all that stuff, you know, when y'all were just born. But he was one of the people that made us do what we're doing right now. And so, since you're here, I guess you like it. So, here we go.
Johnny Winter on the bass.
Yeah.
nobody even cared. Yeah, it seemed nobody loved me. Nobody even cared. Yeah, you talk about hard luck and trouble. I guess we all had our share. Every day. Every day I have the blues. Yeah, when you see me one little girl, it's you I hate to lose. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, every day. Johnny Winter on the bass.
Yeah. I'm over here when there's no place else for me to be, so. It now.
Yeah, thank you all for helping out, those of you who helped out.
I don't know how y'all feel about it, but I think that John Parrish does a real good job on blues and rock and roll. And that, you know, don't y'all? Ain't no jive, ain't no jive.
Thank you, Johnny.
Yeah!
It's a real good job, both of them. So let me see what I can figure. I can do a good job at. Let me see here. Well, the first thing I heard. No, turn this fucker on. Turn this fucking thing on here. Good, good. Put them on about six. No, wait a minute. Wait. This is one time. One time of the night. This is a song that that I always really feel like I have to do it because I love to do the song so much, and sometimes at this time of night you expect everybody to be smashed because we are, and so but this is a song that that. It's real important to me because it's a song that that I had to buy like years ago it's a song I had to get from the Library of Congress, and it's by Willie Brown, a guy that influenced Robert Johnson, Slim House, Muddy Waters, all those early Delta people. And Willie Brown was kind of their idol, and he never had a commercial record ever put out on him, but he was recorded like in the early 40s, and he does things that guitar players now just listen to and think, oh shit, forget that. So anyway, I'm gonna do one of those for you right now. And probably you rock and roll people will be, it'll give you a chance to order your drinks and give each other a head under the table and whatever you want to do, but the people that want to hear blues, you're going to hear some good blues here, because it took me about 6 years to figure out how this son of a bitch did the son of a bitch. He did these two things in a row, he was doing that at the same time he was doing it. And that's impossible. I mean, any guitar player knows that's impossible. But, after a few years, me and Bob Margol and Muddy's guitar player figured out what he was doing. So I'd really like to play this song for you, Okay. It's not the kind of song that you really use a band on, because people in those days, most of them used those metal national guitars, which not only were they loud as hell, but they were loud as hell, and if somebody fucked around with you, they were big enough to where you could just hit them in the head, and you would have no more trouble, which was kind of nice, because you know, they didn't have audiences like this. It'd be maybe like 20 or 30 people. Somebody's giving you trouble, you just go out there and smash them in the head with your guitar. That's real easy. Here it's harder, you know. I gotta find the rope, sure they gotta tell me we're fine out where they are. I gotta go all through this shit and go out there and then maybe break the neck on. No, see, now that's kind of stuff, yeah. I don't like breaking the necks on my guitars here, but I do have a national back in the back that if it really gets serious, I'm still real good at that. In fact, I don't really need my national, sometimes I have fun. Sometimes I have fun being violent. Right now, I would have a real good time playing the song for you all if you would like to hear it, you know. Oh, yeah, I'm glad you said that because probably what I'm going to do in here, even though this is a Willie Brown song, I'm always doing that. I always sneak some Robert Johnson into it because I just love Robert Johnson so much, you know. So anyway, I'm gonna give this a try and see what you all think about this. I mean, when this ain't no rock and roll, all I ask is that the rock and rollers, you know, since it's a little bit quieter, that the rock and rollers shut the fuck up, you know. Thank you.
Thank you.
met the so-and-so name.
Now, little Robert Johnson.
Kind of a woman. She'd do anything in this world for me. The kind of a woman. She'd do anything in this world for me.
She better.
They just will not let me be. Me and the devil. Walking side by side. Me and the devil. Walking side by side. I'm gonna be my woman till I get satisfied.
I realize that it's not the real show, this thing view. Ain't the one thing maybe that really made me drink. Say you don't love me.
I begin to think, oh baby, my life don't mean anything. Just break my heart when I call Mr. So-and-so's name.
What I would see.
Me and the devil walking side by side. Me and the devil was walking side by side. Satisfied.
Yeah, take us in this, this belly freak.
Thank you. Well, do it again, man.
Thank you.
Feel real good about playing tonight is it yeah, we've done some rock and roll and we've done some blues, and I've always heard, I mean, I've played all over the, I've played Europe, everywhere, and you know, it's always the same. You always hear well, people from New York, they don't care about the blues, they don't care about the stuff. That's a bunch of bullshit. I mean, I know that you people do care about what we're doing, you know, and it makes me feel real good. You know, it makes me feel real good. I wish there was more than seven people that, well, maybe y'all don't care, you know, but. Okay, maybe even if they're right, even if most of you people don't care, at least there's a few of you that do. Which makes it. I'm sure happy for the people that do care, because those are the people that we're playing for, really. We're playing for everybody, we're trying to put across good music for everybody, but there's just certain things that we're really trying to get across, you know, and Highway 61 is not one of them. Bob Dylan's done it, I've done it, everybody's heard it. We're trying to get across a lot more than that, and I'm not 24 anymore. Here's Bob Dylan, but it's been a lot of fun. It's been a lot of fun playing for you people, and more than being fun. And I hope there's just a few people here that can appreciate what we're trying to get across. You know. And before we go, I really have to introduce you to the people that are making this music possible. If you care about it at all, if you don't, all you gotta do is just never buy a record or come hear it. You know, that's easy. But if you like it, if you do like it, then let me tell you who's doing it over here, playing. Mostly bass, but he writes, sings, plays guitar. John Ferris, over here, right there. From New York City. Music that can't clap for that is something wrong. It's John Perez, man. Come on, man, go off your asses and clap, man. That's good stuff right there, man. Surely you can understand that's good, right? Okay, here on drums from New Haven, Connecticut is this guy is crazy, and he's crazy, but he plays great drums. And what can I say, man? Any chick strong enough to capture him? I don't know. Well, here he is, Bobby Tirello, Bobby T on drums from New Haven, Connecticut. Thank you. main reason that we do all this stuff, man. There's a lot of crap and stuff, you know. I mean, about yeah, well, everybody does it because you make a lot of bread on the level that we're on, man. But we don't make any money. And if you think we do, just ask them. And anyway, no, really, I mean, the reason we do this stuff is because we love to do it, and we ain't gonna stop until you people stop caring about it. As long as you people keep caring about what we're doing, we'll keep doing it. We ain't thinking about stopping. So, this is Johnny Winter, formerly from Beaumont, Texas, now from New York, and we're gonna whip it on you as long as you want to hear it.
DuBois 7 FM, WLIR Garden City is the radio station. I'm Pam Murley, and that was Johnny Winter, recorded in a rare club appearance over at my father's place in Old Roslyn on September 8th of this year. Tonight's concert was produced and engineered by Jeff Cracky for the Workshop Recording Studio. Broadcast coordination by Dennis McNamara, technical director Michael Billiter, technical assistants Peter Hedeman, and special thanks to Teddy Slatus, Blue Sky Records, the staff and management of my father's place, and of course, Johnny Winter. And the executive producer for the WLIR concert series is Michael Tapes for Audio by Zimmet. And WLIR has a number of great concerts coming up over the next few weeks. We'll tell you about them right now. Starting this Friday night, October 27th, about 9:30, we present Tim Curry in a special live radio concert from my father's place. Tim Curry, as you know, is featured in the Rocky Horror Picture Show. And he also has a brand new solo album out, which I'll play a tune from in just a few minutes. On Saturday, the following night, October 28th at 9 p.m., we present The Grateful Dead in a rare recording of The Dead performing in San Diego back in 1970. The concert is approximately 90 minutes long. And then on Sunday, October 29th at midnight, the Brecker Brothers. We recorded that special concert at my father's place back on October 6th. That is this Sunday night at midnight. And then Tuesday night, October 31st, 1 week from tonight, Halloween, a special repeat of our Emerson, Lake, and Palmer radio concert recorded in February of this year at the Nassau Coliseum. And we will announce details soon on a very special surprise live broadcast coming up on Tuesday night, November 14th. Live radio at LIRFM is produced through the facilities of Audio by Zimmet and the Workshop Recording Studio. Tonight's Johnny Winter concert was brought to you by Datsun and your nearby Datsun dealer, who invites you to see the magnificent all-new 280ZX. The performance quality and the luxury of the new 280ZX make it a fuel-injected value. And by Crazy Eddie, with stores in Syosset, the Bronx, Brooklyn, Manhattan, and Paramus. And here you go, Tim Curry.